Kutahood. Hey, what's up, Kutahood? We can bust up Kutahood. Today I'm gonna be talking about how to get your toddler to speak more. Yay! I just filmed a video, so you're gonna notice the same attire. I didn't feel like switching out clothing to make it look like different days. Aria, she's over here touching everything if you notice a little shaking. Okay, so how to get your toddler to speak more. First, I just wanna say it's 100% normal for a mom, especially a new mom, to feel like, man, is my child speaking enough? And it's very normal to compare your child to other kids. But I just want to reassure you that most likely nothing's wrong, and there's a lot of different factors as to why your child's not speaking at the time people recommend they should be speaking. There could be numerous reasons. First being their ears. Maybe they're not hearing as well as you think. Probably they have fluid backed up in their ear or earwax built up in their ear. So, or even the ear infection. So that could be a reason. Another reason can be, Aria, stop touching, gosh. Another reason that they're not speaking can be that maybe they're not hearing too much speech around them, or maybe you're in a bilingual household. They're probably getting confused. They're probably getting confused if you're in a bilingual household. And then something else too is if they don't have any siblings around their age. So I know for Troy, he is the oldest out of both the kids, but he doesn't have any kids around his age speaking to him often. And a lot of the times with little toddlers and babies, they learn faster with kids around their own age. Yeah, they're gonna learn from parents, but they just learn better and faster from kids around their own age. So having a sibling around their age definitely plays a huge factor in speech. Oh my gosh, these kids are just driving me crazy. Go ahead, go play. So, anyways, it's completely normal to feel like, man, my kid's not speaking enough, and it's completely normal to compare, but every child goes at their own pace. Every child goes at their own pace. Some kids are faster in some areas. Maybe your kid will be walking at 8 months, and some kids walk after 12 months. Does that mean they're gonna, you know, the one that walked later will have behavioral issues later on? No. Absolutely not. You get what I'm saying? Everybody just masters things at their own pace. Some kids have teeth growing in early, some are later. All depends. Every kid is different. But if you want your child speaking and they're probably screaming and crying a lot due to frustration of not being able to get across what they want to say, then here is some tips for you. Number one, get flashcards. You should go to Target. They have the 50 first words and they're really convenient. It's like $3.99. And you just put up a flashcard, apple, 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 and just train them, and constantly show them flashcards. The second tip that I have for you is to let them watch educational speaking shows on YouTube. I've discovered, and it helped Troy, I'll put in the search engine, baby's first words, and it's really nice because there's songs and it's like dog, dog, and I see Troy copying dog, dog. So you really want to put those educational baby first word shows on YouTube, so that they can hear it and visually see it. And even if they're not paying attention to it, they're still kind of hearing it in some way, shape, or form, and it's gonna come across to them. The next tip is to give them options when they want something. So to give them options. So for Troy, I'll say, what do you want? Pretend this is water. Do you want water, juice? Water, juice. Water, juice. Prompts him to point and grab what he wants. But before you just go ahead and give it to them, you make them say the word to earn the item. So if he chooses juice, which most likely he will, I will say juice, and he'll be like, and I'm like, juice? And he'll be like, juice? Jewel, and then I'm like, good job, thank you, or, you know, to get him to say thank you, and he'll usually say thank you. The next tip is to reward for attempting the new words. Let them feel praised. Let them feel, wow, I did something really awesome, because they did. They are expressing themselves. They are using new words. So you really want to excite them and get them really pumped. Wow, good job, Joy. You said a new word. Woo! speak to them as much as possible and try not to use too much baby speech as well. So with Aria, I kind of like sliced that baby speech up because I noticed Troy was moving steps backwards because he was watching me, oh, baby, baby, Aria, and then he started doing it to Aria. He would look at Aria and go, you, you, you. Although it was cute, I'm like, oh gosh, you know, I want him to use words. So now I speak to her normal. Any chance you get, try to speak to your kids, whether it's small or big. And something else too, some parents have told me they don't know what to say to their toddler, like they just don't know how to speak to them and keep their interest. So what I do when I don't know what to say, I'll just be like, Troy, nose, 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 and I wait. Nose, 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 nose. And I do it so much to where he says nose. I point to my eyes, my mouth, my ears, so he can know body placements, colors, all that stuff. Plus it helps because later on I can say, what hurts? Stomach? Belly? You know. So talk to them as much as you possibly can. Use flashcards. Give them options. And then before you just give them the item, force them to ask for it. Force them to say the word. And I know it could be tempting to just be like, here, here, here. Especially if they're screaming or whining. Trust me, if they want it bad enough, they're going to attempt that new word. Choose. It takes time. It's repetition. It's all about repetition. Make sure you repeat, 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 repeat. Okay? Repetition is a key factor. There are some kids out there that there are auditory learners, which is Troy. The first couple days of me pointing to my nose, he did not repeat after me. He just watched me. And then out of nowhere, he started going, nose, 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 out of nowhere. Some kids are paying attention and listening and watching your mouth movement before they attempt the new word themselves. So make sure to keep that in mind. Make sure to praise them and get them excited to speak. And don't compare your baby to others, because every child is in a different household and they may have somebody close to their age, a lot of siblings that are speaking to them more. They may be in daycare around other kids where they are learning to speak a little faster. You know, there's just so many different key factors that come into play with why kids speak faster and all that stuff. But it really doesn't mean any difference. But try to force them to speak if you want them to really speak. And then another thing that I wanted to mention too is if you feel like you don't notice any changes with doing all of these tips, for I will give it like a couple of weeks, if you feel like, man, I don't notice any changes, he's still not speaking, she's still not speaking as much as I want. Aria just took a few steps, so I'm excited. Then get a speech therapist. I think they're free when your child is 0 to 3, and just the visiting aspect, they're free to see them for the first time. So get a speech therapist and see if there is maybe an issue with their motor. Maybe they're tongue-tied, or you never know. So make sure you get that speech therapist in. Nothing to be ashamed about, and they'll tell you, oh, nothing's wrong, he's just a little late speaker. And sometimes they'll say, oh, okay, he has a little motor issue, we'll break him out of that so that he'll speak more. And then make sure that there's nothing wrong with their ears, that they can hear clearly, and you're good to go. One more thing before I forget. Another reason why your child could be a little delayed with speaking is probably because of the pacifier. The pacifier blocks them from speaking. If they're sucking it all the time, they're not going to want to speak. So make sure to try to wean them off at the, just the right time, or take it out of their mouth to try to force them to speak. All right, and that is all. Leave your thoughts, comments down below, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye-bye.